Hey everybody. So if you live in the Northern Hemisphere, the seed catalogs have started piling up in your mailbox. The department stores and gardening centers are full of packets of seed, and you're anxiously watching the weather forecast to find out just how soon can you get that first packet of seed in the ground. But as you start flipping through the catalogs and seeing what's offered on the shelves, you start to scratch your head because you see things like GMO, you see things like hybrid, heirloom, organic, and you're not entirely sure what all of those terms mean. You've perhaps seen reports about genetically modified organisms or GMOs and you're concerned and you don't know what the right way to turn is. Well, I want to address a few of those today without getting too far into detail because I don't want the video to stretch on and on. I want you to just be at a comfortable place where when you go to plant your seeds this spring, you know what you're getting into. I want to start the video by first saying that you can relax a bit about the dangers of you possibly planting GM or genetically modified seed. You simply will not, on accident, purchase GM seed. It's not going to happen. There's no such thing as GM seed sitting on the shelves of your local gardening center. They don't sell it in small packets. Instead, when you do find it, it's in large sacks that are going to cost hundreds of dollars because they're meant to plant acres upon acres of that one crop. So no matter where you stand on the pros or cons of genetically modified seed, don't worry about whether or not you're going to be able to just accidentally purchase and plant some. It's not going to happen. I'll get into more about genetically modified seed in another video. It deserves its own time. So let's get down into what you are actually going to find in your seed catalogs and on the shelves at the store. I went to the store myself and I picked up a few packets of seeds. This was one that says right across the top of it, Heirloom Collection. Now, heirloom seeds are those that are open pollinated and have been around for some time. They've proven themselves as stable varieties, and we know that the seed that they produce is true to seed. Now, what that means is that the seed that comes out of the fruit or out of the flower is going to produce the exact same plant that fruit grew on. The upside of growing open pollinated or heirloom varieties is that you can save the seed. Or said another way, buy the packet once and never ever again. Now the next kind that you might find are hybrid seeds. I picked out this one from the store because it was the most ominous sounding. It says G90 hybrid. That just sounds scientific and doesn't sound like food at all. Now I want to tell you a bit about hybrids. Hybrids are plants that have been selected to be crossbred by a person under controlled circumstances to produce a seed that has certain valuable traits that they can then use that seed to grow new plants. So what that really means is, let's say as you scroll through your catalogs, you see something that says that it's an open pollinated variety and it's known to have a certain disease resistance. And then you see another open pollinated variety that says that it is very good for growing in hot, humid conditions. Well, what if you want both? What if you want something that's resistant to that disease and grows in a hot, humid condition? Well, over time, in the course of hundreds of years, Mother Nature may well devise a strain herself that does that. But some people can't wait that long, and they want to do something right now. So they take two plants, and in a controlled measure, cross-pollinate them to produce a seed that produces a new plant. That new plant has both the traits to be resistant to a disease and do well in a hot and humid condition. And when they have that plant, through controlled methods, they clone it and then they keep producing seed off that same plant and keep selling that seed to you as a hybrid seed. Now the reason they produce it that way is because there's a catch about hybrid seeds. You cannot take the seed off of the plant and expect it to grow true to seed. It will grow, but it's probably not going to grow. There's a lower chance of it growing the same kind of fruit, the same disease resistance or growing tolerance that the seed that you purchased from the store had. Instead, whatever it grows is going to be edible, but it may not have the traits that you were looking for. So the catch is you end up having to go back to whoever developed it to get the seed again. There's nothing genetically modified about it. Instead, it's just someone speeding up natural selection and trying to get the desired traits out of a particular plant that they want. Now, another one that I ran into the store was this, and it simply says organic. Now, this means nothing more than the plants that the seed was harvested from were grown in a way that is in compliance with the USDA, or wherever you live, organics certification standards. It does not mean that the seed itself is heirloom or open pollinated or hybrid. You still need to check into that if that is something that matters to you. Organic means nothing more than the seed was grown or harvested off of a plant that was grown in the standards required by your agency's organic certification standards. So, I hope that sort of summarizes and clarifies some of the things regarding the different kinds of seed packets you're going to find. To put it again into one little bundle, you're not on accident going to buy GM seed. You're not going to find it in the seed catalogs that are coming from the major companies. You're not going to find it sitting on the shelves of the gardening center or the department store. Heirloom or open pollinated seeds mean that whatever you grow, you can harvest the seed and grow the exact same plant again every single year that you harvest. Hybrid seeds means that someone selected some different plants to give you a seed that is going to have a certain disease resistance or other trait to it. And if you want to grow it again, you're going to have to buy the seeds again. I hope that clarify some things for you. Check back in the future. We're going to have a whole nother episode about GM or genetically modified seeds and tell you some of the truths behind GM seed. Thank you all for watching. I hope you liked the video. Please don't forget to share it with your friends. This is something that every planting season I see questions all over social media about what it really means. Share it so that your friends can get the answers that they're looking for. Give us a big thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. As always, we really appreciate you watching, and so does the rooster. We'll see you next time.